In this video, you will learn how to find an ebook by title using library search. You will also learn strategies for choosing between ebook platforms when you have more than one link to pick from, since choosing the first link might not meet your needs. Let's start at the UTM Library website at library.utm.utoronto.ca. Let's imagine that we want to find this book, Playing with Power in Movies, Television, and Video Games, from Muppet Babies to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. When you type in library search, you can ignore punctuation. We recommend that you get into the habit of using quotation marks to make your search an exact phrase so that you can get exactly what you are looking for. Click the search button. Here are our results. There are 216 items. The first item is not an ebook, since it does not say available online. The phrases available at and other locations indicate that this is a physical print copy of the book. The second item is an ebook, but the year indicates that it is an earlier edition or print run. The fifth item is the ebook that we want. We know this because the bibliographic information, the title, publisher, and year all match. Library search categorizes this item as a book, and it tells us that it is available online, so we know that it is an ebook. If we wanted to make sure that we only had records for ebooks, we could use the options on the left-hand side of the screen under Filter Your Results. First, click Online. Then, under Format, click Show More. We want to go ahead and click the box for books, and then click Apply Filters. Now, we just have the two ebooks and have removed all of the other items. As mentioned earlier, the bibliographic information is the deciding factor since we want the book published in 1993. So let's go ahead and click the title for the second item record. There is just one link under Full Text Availability labeled Access Content in American Council of Learned Societies. This is the link that we will use to access the ebook. So let's go ahead and click that. You will now be directed to log in with your UTOR ID and password, just as you would log into your University of Toronto email. We have now accessed the ebook. Usually, if there are any limits to the number of people who can read a book at one time or to the amount of content that you are able to download, these will be listed toward the top of the ebook record. We don't see any limits to the number of users or to the amount of pages that we can download listed here. Let's scroll down to the table of contents. There's no way to download this book all at once. We can download each chapter individually. Since it is possible that there might be some download limits that we just aren't seeing, it is wise to download the chapters that we know that we want first. You can also read this book online. In general, we recommend that you download readings instead, particularly if it is an assigned reading, since there might be limits to the number of people who can read a book, and we want to make sure that everyone gets a chance to access the ebook. One reason that you might want to look through the ebook before downloading is when it is not an assigned reading. We see that this ebook allows us to full text search by keyword. We might want to search keywords before downloading to see if the book will be useful for our research. Let's look at another ebook that has links to access the ebook through multiple platforms. The ebook Education and Gender Equality has four links. Three of the links are to different platforms. And if we open up all three, we see that the platforms look quite different and provide different amounts of content for us to download. This first version of the ebook through Scholars Portal Books informs us that unlimited readers are allowed. We're told that we can download up to 56 pages of this book. Notice that the start page is page 1, and this corresponds to the cover of the book. As we scroll through the book, you will notice that the start page changes, but does not correspond with the actual pages of the book. For instance, according to the table of contents, chapter 1 starts on page 3, but according to the platform, we are already on page 5. So if we wanted to download chapter 1, then we would need to enter the start page as page 12. So that's a bit complicated. It isn't insurmountable, but if you just need to download a chapter, this platform requires you to do a little bit of thinking and strategizing. Let's look at the second platform for accessing this ebook through Taylor and Francis. In this platform, there are no indications of any limits. If we click download, we in fact get the whole book. If we scroll down the page, we can see that chapters are clearly delineated, and we can easily download any of these. So that is clearly an easy, no-fuss way to access this ebook in its entirety or by chapter. For our third and final option, ProQuest eBook Central, we see that, like the other two options, there are no limits to the number of users. Like the second book, we can download the entire book, but unlike the second book, which could be downloaded with the click of a single button, this platform requires us to sign up with ProQuest eBook Central and use third-party software. This isn't really easy to use, and you might not want to put that software on your computer. We can download up to 70 pages, but with this platform, we want to start by clicking Read Online, then click Print to PDF. None of this is exactly intuitive. Returning to the library search record for this book, we see that all three links to the ebook platforms work just fine. But for this book, the second link provides us with the most content and is the easiest to use. This is not to say that one ebook platform is necessarily better than others, but this example drives home the point that when you encounter more than one link to an ebook, it can be worth taking a little extra time to explore them to find the one that will best suit your needs and be easiest to use. If you need any help, feel free to email us at askutml.utm@utoronto.ca. Use the online chat from the UTM Library homepage or reach out to us over Zoom, and we can help.